Hey everyone, in this video, we're going to be talking about strings in C++. We'll talk about what strings are, how you can store strings, and we'll go over a bit about how you can use strings in the C++ programming language. As in a lot of programming languages, strings are going to be one of the most common data types you encounter and use. Strings in C++ are strings of characters. Characters being just about any button you can hit on your keyboard, and a string meaning connected together. Strings are basically a data type that allow us to insert plain language into our coding program. So, let's start very simple and print out a basic string with our YouTube name. To print a string in C++, we type cout, which stands for character output. So, when we put this, we are telling C++ we want to output the following bit of information. Then our two arrows, which are bitwise shift operators. Then we enter the string that we want to print between two quotation marks. This tells C++ that we are defining a string. Then we end it with another bitwise shift operator and an end of line statement and a semicolon. Now, if we build this simple program, we will receive StudySession in our output console as expected. Equivalently, we could also include a backslash n inside our string to tell C++ that we want the line to end here. If you were to exclude either of these, the C++ compiler will print it all out on one line, like so. So, you can see what I mean here. Commonly, we usually have strings stored inside variables, and not just implemented raw into the print statement, so we should cover how to do that as well. To create a new variable, we must first tell the C++ compiler what type of data our variable is going to be. So, we state that string, and then our variable name, YouTube channel, and then equals our variable value inside the double quotation marks. Then we can simply take this variable and plug it into the middle of our print statement, just like we did earlier. And as you can see here, we are returned the exact same output as before. I also want to quickly talk about the using namespace std line we have at the top of our C++ program here. This just means that we are using the standard namespace. I will have a link in the description below that will help you better understand what namespaces are within C++, and why we need to explicitly state that we are using the standard namespace. Just for now, understand that without including this line, you will receive an error. You could, if you choose, also include the namespace identifier at the beginning of all your statements if you wish. However, it is often more efficient and easier just to include that one line statement at the top of your C++ program. Thank you for checking out this video, and I hope it helped your understanding about how we store and print strings in C++. If you enjoyed, please like, subscribe, and consider checking out our Patreon to support the channel. However, if you have any comments, questions, or concerns about the information I provided in this video, please leave a comment down below, and I will do my best to address your concerns.